102.7 Sound FM, off and running here with the Soulless News Show. This is Bald Boy, 102.7 Sound FM, and that was Seven Screaming Dizbusters from Tyranny and Mutation from Blue Oyster Cult in 1973. Bald Boy behind the mic tonight, 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time here in, I'm in Kitchener or Waterloo here. Anyway, Waterloo region, and you can listen to us at soundfm.ca and just choose your method of listening. Just go to the Listen Live tab and then choose. And it looks like our YouTube thing is going tonight. I'm on there. I can see myself here in the studio as we get into the show Monday night, 8 to 10. Classic rock, deep cuts, and the occasional single you haven't heard in a while. I got some planned. At least I just got to go through my list. But anyway, I was looking around at some stuff from that I might want to play that you haven't heard in a long time. I've started kind of doing that a bit more. It's a deep cut show, but every now and then I like to throw in a single that you haven't heard in eons. But anyway, enough talk. Back to rock. Here's Tunnel of Love from Making Movies from Dire Straits in 1980 at Sound FM.
Like it always did. Oh, like the Spanish city too. When are we? carousels in the carnival arcade, searching everywhere from steeplechase to palisades, in any shooting gallery where promises are made to walk away, walk away, walk away, walk away from color coats and Whitley Bay. Had to walk away. And girl, it looks so pretty to me, like it always did, like the Spanish city to me when we were kids. Girl, it looks so pretty to me, like it always did, like the Spanish city to me when we were kids.
Stealer with a silence and comfort. Well, she's a woman of the world, and God, she knows it. She turns my head every time she shows it.
Well, 102.7 Sound FM, there's some early and excellent Aerosmith from Get Your Wings in 1974, a track called Woman of the World. Aerosmith at Sound FM. Started the set with Dire Straits, Tunnel of Love, and as I mentioned before, I played the track, playing some singles tonight, but ones you haven't heard in a long time, perhaps. Maybe you've heard Tunnel of Love by Dire Straits, which did top 50, just outside the top 50, but it's obviously a well-known song from Dire Straits from the Making Movies album in 1980, their third one. And then George Harrison with It's What You Value from 33 and a Third, which is the... You don't have to mention that now because vinyl's back. But 33 and a Third revolutions per minute on a full album, unlike 78s or 45s, etc. Anyway, George Harrison with It's What You Value from 33 and a Third in 76, and he wrote that about... apparently he... I guess on his 74 tour, he had Jim Keltner, the drummer, play with him, and a well-known session drummer, and played for all kinds of people. And Harrison paid him not with money, but with a Mercedes. So, and he wrote the song about that. Yeah, it was a single in England. It wasn't released as a single over here. And then Aerosmith with Woman of the World. Speaking of singles, this was a single, and... I'm thinking you probably haven't heard it in a long time. Jerry Rafferty, who had a difficult life, alcoholic. Anyway, he came to prominence with Steeler's Wheel, of course, and then on his own with the song Baker Street from City to City, and then this track on the follow-up album, Night Owl, Days Gone Down. This was a relatively fairly big hit single for Jerry Rafferty. But did well in Canada, and I think it was top 20 in the States. Anyway, Jerry Rafferty, song you hopefully haven't heard in a long time. Days Gone Down, great track.
Thank you.
And I
Winston,
huh?
Welcome to the show.
Michael, it's a pleasure to be here.
It's really nice to have you, John. As you know, I've admired your work for so long and haven't been able to get together with you so much as
I
want.
It's not been my fault, Michael.
Do you remember that old place off Broadway?
Oh, those are the days I want to hold your man. Remember that.
John, I want to talk to you about your new group, the Dirty Mac,
sure.
Which you've got together for tonight's show.
Well,
comprises of yourself. And
myself, that's Winston Legthigh, you know. And we've got Mitch Mitchell from the Jimi Hendrix Experience.
Oh, you really?
Yeah,
experienced.
Really. Oh, very, very. You've read my file. And we've got Eric Clapton from the Cream, the late, great Cream.
Cream.
Michael, the
fantastic.
Late, great. And we've got Keith Richard, your own soul brother.
Dirty.
Great. I'd like just to give you this, Mike.
On thank you, John.
Of the British public.
You're a blues, John. You're
same
a blues,
you,
John.
Michael.
You're blues, John.
The reason. The reason why.
102.7 Sound FM. That is the Dirty Mac, as introduced by Keith Richards, or by Mick Jagger and John Lennon in 1968, December, from the Rolling Stones Rock and Roll Circus. And as they mentioned going in, they're doing the Beatles Year Blues, Lennon on rhythm guitar and lead vocals, Eric Clapton on lead guitar, Keith Richards on bass, and Mitch Mitchell of the Jimi Hendrix Experience on drums. And they just re-released the Stones Rock and Roll Circus expanded version on CD and DVD and Blu-ray. So there's some extra stuff, including some extra stuff from the Dirty Mac, some extra Taj Mahal. No extra Stones. The Stones do 6 tracks on this album. The Who, of course, on it. Marianne Faithful, Jethro Tull, Song for Jeffrey with, if you watch the movie, and I've had the original movie now, it's remastered and re-released and expanded. Tony Iommi was playing guitar. Yes, Tony Iommi was playing guitar for Jethro Tull at the Rock and Roll Circus. Because that was after, I guess, Mick Abrahams had left, and they didn't have Martin Barr in the lineup yet. Okay, so we started the set with, what did we start with? Jerry Rafferty. Days Gone Down, in brackets, Still Got the Light in Your Eyes, which was a top 20 hit single for him in Canada, and from the Night Owl album in the late 70s. And he went back to back two really good albums. The first one with Baker Street on it, and then the Days Gone Down from Night Owl, the late great Jerry Rafferty, who was also, of course, in Steeler's Wheel, and Stuck in the Middle with You fame. And then Howlin' Wolf, more Stones sort of incorporated, and Clapton and so on. It was Howlin' Wolf with Killing Floor from the London Howlin' Wolf sessions that also featured, backing him was Clapton, Steve Winwood from Traffic and Blind Faith, Bill Wyman on bass, and Charlie Watts from the Stones helping him out. And Winwood does not play on that track. It's actually an extra track called London Revisited from the London Revisited extra sessions on the expanded version, 2-disc version of that London Howlin' Wolf sessions. And then we have the Dirty Mac with the Beatles Year Blues, done by Lennon, Clapton, Mitch Mitchell, and Keith Richards at the Rolling Stones Rock and Roll Circus. Speaking of the Beatles, last night I was just looking around YouTube and partially planning my show, and it turned out that this came up for my show. I hit upon, you remember the Shea Stadium concert in 1965, where you couldn't really hear the Beatles, because during that time period, of course, the girls were screaming. It's just comical. It's fun to watch. But anyway, the first big stadium show, really. It's just so weird to watch, too. They run out onto the stage. They're right in the middle of the field, where nowadays that would be the standing room or the seats. And the story goes that, it's true, they redid the vocals and some of the instrumentation on it because they just couldn't, the tapes were just so, because of the screaming and stuff, was just not worth it. But anyway, it's a really good YouTube video now, half an hour or so. A lot of Beatles stuff gets taken down eventually on YouTube. But anyway, it's up there for now, the Beatles at Shea Stadium. So anyhow, they played Babies in Black from Beatles for Sale, otherwise known as Beatles 6 in the States. And I like the version, the live version, so I'm going to play the recorded version here, the Beatles with Babies in Black from Beatles for Sale.
was the 3rd of June, another sleepy, dusty Delta day. I was out chopping cotton and my brother was baling hay. And at dinner time we stopped and walked back to the house to eat. And Mama hollered at the back door, y'all remember to wipe your feet. And then she said, I got some news this morning from Choctaw Ridge. Today, Billy Joe McAllister jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. And Papa said to Mama as he passed around the black-eyed peas, well, Billy Joe never had a lick of sense. Pass the biscuits, please. There's 5 more acres in the lower 40 I got to plow. And Mama said it was a shame about Billy Joe anyhow. Seems like nothing ever comes to no good up on Choctaw Ridge. And now Billy Joe McAllister's jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. Brother said he recollected when he and Tom and Billy Joe and put a frog down my back at the Carroll County Picture Show. And wasn't I talking to him after church last Sunday night? I'll have another piece of apple pie. You know it don't seem right. I saw him at the sawmill yesterday on Choctaw Ridge. And now you tell me Billy Joe's jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. Mama said to me, child, what's happened to your appetite? Well, I've been cooking all morning and you haven't touched a single bite. That nice young preacher, Brother Taylor, dropped by today. Said he'd be pleased to have dinner on Sunday. Oh, by the way, he said he saw a girl that looked a lot like you up on Choctaw Ridge. And she and Billy Joe was throwing something off the Tallahatchie Bridge. A year has come and gone since we heard the news about Billy Joe. Brother married Becky Thompson, they bought a store in Tupelo. There was a virus going round, Papa caught it and he died last spring. And now Mama doesn't seem to want to do much of anything. And me, I spend a lot of time picking flowers up on Choctaw Ridge and drop them into the muddy water off the Tallahatchie Bridge.
I could listen to that song a million times over. Bobby Gentry from 1967, number one single, number one album. Ode to Billy Joel here at Sound FM. I told you I was going to play some singles you hadn't heard in a long time today. And normally this is a deep cut show, and I'm playing a fair bit of singles, but a lot of them you have not heard, I don't think, in a long time. Ode to Billy Joel. I'm not sure. There's several versions of that on YouTube, actually. One in a BBC live rendition, and it's brilliant, too. But that's the original from the original album in 1967, and... Bobby Gentry got out of the music industry in 1981, I guess. She just got tired of it. She sang and wrote all her own stuff, which was different for, especially for a woman at the time. And just a brilliant track. And she's got some great stuff besides that. It's just one of those things where you know, massive hit single, and she did it. So, you know, people say one hit wonder. I don't think so. She had another one, Fancy, it's called, but just a fantastic track. I'm not sure what brought me to that the other day. I was just, you know, just searching music, and I came across it by some means of search, and yeah, fantastic. Okay, total change of pace now from Bobby Gentry. Here is Social Distortion. This was a single for them, too, back in 96. This is actually the track and the album that got me into Social Distortion. It's White Light, White Heat, White Trash, and this is I Was Wrong. Mike Ness and the boys at Sound FM.
Girlfriend's been tripping, I heard her say. changed his hair colors just to match the day. What in the world? What in the world? What in the world's going on in your world? Run away, play a tune, dance it off, baby, like you used to do. Drive away, find the view, shake it off, baby, it's just them blues. Girlfriend's been seeing some therapist.
Let's go, Sam. baby, let's get married. We're too young to die, a little damn to carry. The sun takes forever to get down in the hole, and in the dirty old place of dead rattling room. I still can't remember anything I loved about you.
Scared all along the way, wandering, looking to hide.
Linda Ronstadt from 1973. What a bloody amazing voice. Sadly silenced by Parkinson's disease. That is Linda Ronstadt with Love Has No Pride, which was a single, but only did top 50, or actually top 60. But it's yet become one of her most well-known songs, or one of them. So many great ones. Linda Ronstadt, what an amazing, amazing voice. All right, this is 102.7 Sound FM. This is Bald Boy Sold. It's a new show, Old Bands, Old Tracks. Old bands are new stuff, if they're still around, alive and kicking. Usually go deep cuts, but tonight I keep, I don't know, it's just the show takes on a life of its own in a way. And I've been playing some, I guess you'd call them minor hit singles, or stuff that you haven't heard in a long time, I don't think, or stuff that I haven't heard in a while, so I just thought I'd play them. There was one number one single, Bobby Gentry, way back with Ode to Billy Joe, and just a classic track. And that followed up, started the next set with Social Distortion with I Was Wrong. Collective Soul from their new album, a track called Them Blues, just came out. It's called Blood. And Collective Soul, I really like their sound. They don't really have hit singles anymore either. They've already been around for about 20 years. You'll remember them from the mid-90s. And they actually played here in Kitchener at that, I can't remember what it was called now, that rock festival that Aerosmith played at. And then the next year, Soundgarden and Rod Stewart and Blondie didn't show up. Soundgarden did. And then that was the end of it. Collective Soul with Them Blue is an interesting track. Then Lee Harvey Osmond from one of my favorite artists, as I always mention when I play him, Tom Wilson. Excuse me, Tom Wilson with Lee Harvey Osmond, What I Loved About You, from his most recent release last year, Mohawk. And of course, Tom Wilson, who was at a blues festival here with Junkhouse a few years back, and I've seen him solo. And he also with Blackie and the Rodeo Kings. Then Little Feet from the last record album in 1975 with Romance Dance, and then Linda Ronstadt with Love Has No Pride. Now here's a deep cut. I played this a long time ago on this show. It's from Fleetwood Mac's Time album, which kind of bombed. There's no Stevie Nicks, no Lindsey Buckingham on this one. When did this album come out? 1995. Anyhow, the lineup is Becca Bramlett on vocals from and Dave Mason and of Traffic fame and solo stuff, and Billy Burnett. I'm losing my voice here. Billy Burnett on guitars, Christine McVie, John McVie, and Mick Fleetwood. It's an okay album. This is my favorite track on it, though, and it's got Mick Fleetwood quote-unquote singing. It's actually spoken word. These Strange Times. Dig it.
starved in Metropolis. Hooked on Necropolis. Addict of Metropolis. Do the worm on Acropolis, slam dance Cosmopolis, enlighten the populace.
With hatred in their eyes, I can't help thinking that it's only a disguise. 'Cause underneath that core, there's gotta be more than what we realize. Maybe they're scared to let the inside out. Maybe they're afraid to show what they're all about. So they put on a heavy front and hope that no one else can work them out. So they put on all the heaviness, but it's only illusion heaviness. Can't you see? In case a little bit of emotion gives them away. Look at that lady dancing round with no clothes. She'll give you all her body, that's if you've got the dough. She'll let you see most anything, but there's one thing that she'll never show. That's a little bit of real emotion, a little bit of true emotion. In case a little bit of emotion gives her away. But it's a shame she's acting that way. Somehow she's got to get through every day. In case a little bit of emotion gives her away. People learn their lines, they act out their part. They talk on cue, but it's got no heart. It's all on the surface, it's all contrived. They're scared to come out.
The things you wanted,
That is Gram Parsons leading the Flying Burrito Brothers with the Stones' Wild Horses from 1970's Burrito Deluxe. Actually came out before Sticky Fingers, the Stones gave it to him. Keith Richards gave it to him in late 69, the story goes. They were good pals, at least for a couple of years. And Gram Parsons and Keith Richards, that is. Started the set with Fleetwood Mac from the Time album, a somewhat forgotten album because it didn't have Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham on it, and David Mason played guitar on it, and that was a song, a spoken word track, "These Strange Times" by with Mick Fleetwood, the drummer, singing it or talking it. Then the Clash with my favorite track off Combat Rock, "Ghetto Defendant." Interesting track, to say the least. The Kinks with "A Little Bit of Emotion" from Low Budget, and then the Flying Burrito Brothers with the Stones' "Wild Horses." Gonna wrap things up. DJ Mason is due in next. This is his on week, so we'll see if he's in. And gonna close out with a long track from Santana, from a track originally on the Abraxas album. This one's a live, lengthy version from Lotus album in 1974, and this is "Incident at Neshabur," Santana live to close out my show here tonight. Thanks for listening. Sold is new, old bands, old tracks, and this is Bald Boy signing off till next Monday. See ya.